Chairman. I'm very concerned about the growing problem of freight trains blocking grade crossings in urban and suburban communities across our country, particularly Indianapolis. The trains have gotten longer, especially downtown. And I think it's important that this committee and our regulatory partners, quite frankly, take steps to better understand what is happening and how the problem can be essentially fixed. Are investigations being conducted as we speak, and what have you learned so far? And beyond what you can tell me today, we'd appreciate more information and detail in writing. I know we have limited time, and a separate briefing would be very helpful.
Great. Well, one thing I'd like to ask of you or your staff, if you would follow up with us after this, we have a rail customer and public assistance office that we would be, you know, there are times when crossings are occurring and the carrier needs a phone call and a nudge, like, what, you know, what can we do to try to address, you know, ASAP kind of a matter. So if, please don't hesitate, all of you, I will leave the phone number with our office so that we can try to be as responsive and timely on like, occasionally that could be almost an emergency situation. You know, hospitals can't be blocked. You know, we want to be helpful to you. With respect to our investigative new powers, you know, we did implement regulations to establish regulations on our investigations. We have not conducted a formal investigation at this point. That's not to say that it is not a very helpful tool. It's actually a very big stick of authority that you've given us. What our first preference is to exhaust our informal approaches. You know, we want the railroads to work with us and with their shippers and other carriers to work with an appropriate way to try to address issues. And a formal investigation, as you can imagine, will have a bit of a chilling effect on the person or the entity perhaps being investigated. So I'm not saying that, you know, there may be the right time and place for that, but to the extent we can exhaust our work in an informal way, that is the way we'd like to do it, particularly because it also is a transparent process. It's not done confidentially.
Mm-hmm. You know, we're seeing delays up to 3 hours now, which has become extremely problematic, especially for folks trying to get to work and emergency vehicles. So if we could have a separate briefing, that would be tremendously helpful.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Secondly, your written testimony mentioned some adjustments from your previous affiliation with the DOT and now your status as an independent agency. Can you describe some of the outstanding cybersecurity and information technology challenges that should be addressed, and what are your top priorities in this area?
When we became independent, we actually suddenly became responsible for everything we do, and that included our all of our IT network, our financial network, et cetera. Some of the answers I'd like to give to you in private,
sure.
If you don't, and I'm sure you can appreciate why, but I will say that it is a top priority of my colleague and me. And the board staff, frankly, they're working very hard to address some of our vulnerabilities. Mm-hmm. I will also say that much of it is about paperwork.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you. I yield back, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Carson. Mr. Katko, recognized for 5 minutes.